Yep.
3, 2.
What's going on? We here, man. Me and Chase done took over the, I don't never say the name right either. The Little Black Book Podcast show today. I'm Antoine Miles.
Y'all know what's up. I'm Chase.
Go, baby.
Shania.
All right. So, before we get into the guests, April 17th, P-Day. April 18th, BCE Day. But let me talk about P-Day real quick.
Yeah.
We ain't had, it's been 2 years since we've been, you know, been able to do P-Day due to COVID, due to phones ringing, due to, you know what I'm saying, just a lot of shit. But I got an email this morning, and they tried to shut us down.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they were shooting lies around. Some bullshit happened. Anyway, the bullshit is squared away. P-Day still going on, still going down.
Beat up. I'm ready to play kickball.
Oh, yeah. My dog on the team. This ain't the Orlando versus Apaka kickball game. And we only lost the first kickball game because these niggas had a professional bowler pitching the ball. So that's all I got to say. But we're going to get into Miss Shania here.
Hey, y'all. How y'all doing? Some of y'all know me by calling me, some of y'all know me by Shania. But what I do, I make clothes, custom clothes. I make kids' clothes, adults' clothes, and men jeans. Y'all can follow me on my business page at i_tastecustoms on IG and Shania Roberts on Facebook.
Okay, so the reason why I chose you for Antoine's Beat of the Week is because throughout the course of the years, I've been following you and whatnot. You got a raw ass, you know, you got a raw ass style, flavor. A lot of people fuck with you. A lot of people share your stuff. You got a big support system. You feel me? So, one thing I did notice: a lot of people say they'll do one thing, but it's different from saying you'll do something than actually doing it. So you said you want to do the clothes, which wasn't shocking to none of us, probably.
Right. Right. It felt right in line.
Yeah, I feel like that's what you was here for. So. What made you really want to do it, and what got you, you know, to keep going?
Okay, so maybe 2019, I was like going out a lot, clubbing. You know, I like to dress up, I like to get fly, I like to take pictures, I like to make money. But yeah, back on that, there was a lot of people hitting me up like, hey, you know, you dress so fly, you should style people. So I'm like, how I'm gonna do it? Like, what I'm gonna start? Then, you know, as the customers went rolling in, I found myself styling people. That was 2019. I didn't sit down, I didn't plan that, it just happened. So 2020, I actually sat down and I planned. I wrote me a vision board. I had to start somewhere. And it's like, I watched my vision board just come and so tell me, like, right in front of my eye.
You had plenty of time to sit down in 2020.
Yeah, we definitely did. And I used that time wisely. I made a lot of money. I met a lot of people. I traveled for the first time. I went to New York. It was business. I went to like the fabric stores. I checked out like a lot of different things while I was there. And it just, when I came back, it was on. Definitely was on.
You showed on your shit though.
Appreciate you.
I'm fucking with it. You know what I'm
saying?
Yeah, oh yeah, and I do want to.
Is that a new thing?
So,
I ain't know nothing about that. That's so, just
dropped. Look, I'm going to be honest now. You know, I've been missing a couple of shows, you feel me? I've been missing a couple. I've been very busy this year, this corona season. But I just feel like, you know, we got a brain,
yeah,
different things, you know.
It was
to,
new.
To
you
see.
Know what I'm saying? I like it. When I see that, I said, I'm like, okay, I like that.
Yeah, I like it.
That fits you too. I like it.
Yeah, you feel me? And then another thing I do want to say. You, you gotta be picked for the beauty of the week.
Oh, they can't be a DM.
You can't be like, I'm gonna be the beauty of the week. Like, what the
fuck? I mean, but I see why everybody would want a chance.
Yeah, I understand.
You know,
that. But that's why I said, no.
But you just let them know, like,
you definitely have to put that work in. Yeah. Put that work in. You gotta see you grinding. Eventually, you'll get a seat at the
bus
table. Okay. You
heard what you just said. I'm talking about forks and spoons must be cut. For real. Then we got my boy BB over here, you know what I'm about the PD for a long time. Go on ahead and explain who you is. If you know Vivi, you know what it is. Ain't no baby crying either. But I think I've been knowing you for a little while.
Yeah.
I think I ran across you. A lot of your music with Move Boy. I know you get out a lot. Move, you feel me? Yeah, before then too. I used to listen to a lot of Fresh. I pulled up home with my big brother Bones one time. I forgot where we was at, but I know you have a studio. I don't pull it up on you. They gave me a lot of insight on the rap business, you know, in the game. Just tell me how it is out here.
Oh, you
said
he was giving
you all. Yeah, I had to pull it up on him. Yeah. You know, I wanted to rap at one time. You know,
I'm like, you were rapping though,
right? Yeah, I was rapping. I was rapping. Yeah, a long time ago, but it was people I used to listen to from the city. Like,
right.
If you from Orlando,
like, it's certain that you know, you don't know if you're from
what, rapping? Not really. I really wouldn't.
Yeah,
it ain't funny no more. I can help other people, you know, do other things. I like, man, taking me to other places, you know. But the music did help though. The music helped a lot of shit, you feel me? It helped me do a lot of things. Like with the promotion, you feel me? It definitely helped me. But with the connection, like, I know him through the music, you feel me? Like, that's how I met BB. That's how I met a lot of people that come on the show.
Yeah, me too.
Because of the music.
Yeah.
But what made me want to rap was when I was legit coming up, I used to listen to BB. I used to listen to, you know, I Strong. Like, niggas, I used to listen to D-Boy, you feel me? If you from the city, you listen to city music.
Right.
Like, if you from Orlando, you gonna jam niggas who from around here because, you know, they your homeboys. These niggas hard. Like, niggas sound real good, you feel me? So,
what
I can tell
them. What made you, like, even start?
Rap. Well,
yeah.
I think I was in a program. I had went to a program.
What's in you pushing?
sit. You know, like I said, sometimes you know you just feel like, come on.
I know, bro. Yeah, I know.
Yes, you did. I was just being real. I think I seen you one time when you had got out one time with Pimp. Where Paul was at? Right on 33rd with Paul and Pimp. We'll talk about it later.
Yeah.
But I hadn't seen you. And we hadn't talked to y'all somewhere. But it was like after you hadn't got out of trouble. You feel me?
I go hard, then I just, you know what I'm saying? You probably be trying to mix certain shit, but right now, I just, you know, that shit be getting old as fuck. Like trying to mix it, if you gonna do this or you gonna do that.
You know what I'm saying? You realize some people will never get old.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Or it'll be too late.
Yeah.
So.
That music in you, you gonna go back to it. Definitely gonna go back into it. But look, listen, man. You know, that was a few insights on the guest. So today's topic, I know y'all looking at it like, what the fuck, tomorrow on rope on the topic. I've been seeing a lot of shit, the sweetie shit going on, you feel me? People saying Quavo beat it and all this shit. So my whole thing is, the topic say, would you stay with your nigga or your female, even if you get your ass whooped? Or you got your ass whooped. I mean, I was a victim of domestic violence. This one chick, she was getting fucked, dude. Oh, God, I'm telling you, that
ain't
got a
advantage.
Shit.
Around that time, I was like, what, 25, 30? Something wet.
What's your weight right now, though?
154. 154. I took my, I got a little weight still running up on the toilet. So, yeah, I'll be. 25
left in this?
Yeah, search me. But listen, I should kick it in the motherfucker, man. That bit mean, though. And she real. She mean shit. She's like, slap shit out my just get mad, like, oh, I feel like you cheating. Bam. Yeah, we're not talking about rap. But I stayed. But that was abuse.
It really was.
It's abuse. At the end of the day, it's abuse, bro.
They try not to act like niggas don't be getting abused, but they do.
Niggas get abused. I mean,
some of them don't want to put their hands on females. Some of them be scared.
Yeah, I mean, it was abuse at the end of the day. Bullying nigga. I mean, I bullied her at one point, you know, when you do a thing, but other than that, that motherfucker was crazy, bro. Like, I was in an abusive relationship. Like I said, I didn't leave, come home and said, never be no punk, you know, punk out. But I'm single right now, so what that mean? You know, that shit, I love
it. You out of there, y'all
punked out. Shit got old. Would you stay with a beaten female? Like, have you ever been with an abusive female?
Oh my God.
After a while, like that should have gone on a little bit, but nah, you ain't definitely putting my hands on me.
That's crazy. I ain't put my hands on you unless I'm expecting to get that. But I feel like that shit coming. That shit is very, very coming.
What?
Especially that shit comes as fuck.
What, like
a relationship? Oh yeah, like a relationship.
Like,
way more coming.
Fine.
Yeah, whoa, going straight to domestic violence period. Like, that shit is very common. Like, that sweetie shit, I don't think that boy beat that girl up. I'm sorry. I didn't have a relationship with me and that bitch bumping. That shit right there, she sat that game bag. You know what time it was. You touched that game?
Oh, yeah, that PS5 now?
Bro, you come with that game, you know that's why she went for that bag. You ain't grab that black bag, you grab that other bag. Then he was trying to get that bag back from her and
the song
and then like, fuck.
Oh, he had the game system and I see why they were having like
that. But it's like, if you can see, he was on his way out the door. He had on his shit was packed. You know what I'm saying? He had on the bag. Like, he had three bags with him, so clearly you're exiting.
I don't think he did anything.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, as far as females putting hands on males, it's not okay, but it happens sometimes.
She be beating.
And if it continues to happen, that's a problem. You don't want a girl just being on you. That just makes you seem like a pussy.
I stayed 4 months.
4 months? That's a long time. You probably like, okay, like, well, like, okay, you hit me, you probably do eat the licks, not the way you probably like, man, fuck that shit.
Ain't like that bitch beat me every day, y'all. Don't take that to run with it.
She got a schedule.
Don't take it to run with it. She did well off the chain, bro. She did well. When I tell you what it is, you
gonna stay. Facebook, you said you stayed with her because she had.
Yeah,
she did.
Yeah, that's what it is. But you know that toxic
shit, though. That's why people get beat up, like females get beat up, they said they because we got a bag.
Like, I swear to God, when we drive on, bro, we drive on our food, bro. We don't know where to go eat. But her and one of my sister, she stopped. She stopped the car in the middle of our food. Swear to God.
Oh,
you're dealing with some. You need some counseling. Like, so this is like, this, I'm making your eyes, they glistening. I'm getting some help, like. Yeah, she only get a bottle of that at one point, bro. But that's neither here nor there, man. That's neither here nor there. But yeah, that is the topic. I mean, that is a serious conversation, though. Domestic violence is serious. Even though I'm paying about it and shit like that.
You stay at a leave.
Who, me? You ever beat a nigga?
Mm-mm.
You ever try to beat a nigga?
I mean, I have sold on a nigga before, but I can't get mad. And I know I can't. So, like, it's levels to it. I ain't just gonna be out here crashing because I don't like the, I don't even like confrontation with stuff like that. So,
I don't got time.
I avoid it.
I don't got time. I don't know what some
weed
you got going on. I really
he ain't really do shit. He just grab the ass, throw the ass in the elevator. Get your ass in there, give me my shit. Yeah. It's his regular relationship. And then he stayed by the elevator, made sure she got out. She see that what cut. She was dramatic as fuck.
Well, she didn't want to
get up and go.
She probably, I mean,
look.
She could have really hit her hip. You feel me? But at the end of the day, you did the most. That to me, it looked like you followed that nigga. You followed him out the door.
Exactly.
So you wanted confrontation. He was on his way out the door, you followed him. So
she gotta have.
I don't care what y'all say, y'all know I don't give a fuck. The bitch would be like,
yo,
she
ride
as fuck. I don't care.
Yo, heavy fighting, though. You fighting niggas, so it's all good.
That ain't, don't make it
just
seem like I'm like domestic violence. Like, I don't fight niggas like that.
Oh.
But I will. Like, I have.
I know.
We not talking about me right now.
I just can see it, too.
And my answer is no, I'm not staying. I'm still, no, let me, okay. I'm probably lying. Because I didn't been in a relationship when we was fighting, I wasn't getting my ass beat. But we were getting that bitch to go bump it, then after a while, I was like, bro, I'm tired of this shit, bitch. Like,
it's done.
It's done. Like, bitch, I'm gonna change. I ain't got time for this shit. But, so yeah, I would, but not no more.
Yeah.
Bitch ain't gonna fuck with this. You hit me. I'm probably gonna shoot you. I'm just gonna keep it real. All I know is, oh, I blanked out. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. I don't know what the fuck happened. I remember getting hit, and everything went black.
Speaking of shooting people, hey, bro, you heard that diss track? That Young Miss shit?
I heard it.
Ooh, what?
That video was wrong.
Yeah, it is. That's wrong. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Nope.
That's the type of song that make you like, bro, I gotta go kill this nigga. You feel me? Like, yeah. Bitch, you got me fucked up. Bitch, you ain't finna embarrass be like this. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, I can't imagine what I would be. Like,
that's crazy. I mean, it ain't shit. That's the way
of
the world. That's what it is though right now. And that shit's so catchy, bro. It is. It is. Just like another young dog situation. Play with your bitch.
Yeah, that shit's
they
try
to fuck out that shit in the club. I know
that's
why they had
to whip
him up.
Got him
in there
to
everywhere he
went.
Like, that was
a
banger.
Like, that's the whole diss song. That's like, that type of shit don't, like, I feel like I kind of hate the way rap going with that type of shit. Because now it's like, if you're a rapper, if you die, you smoke. If you're a rapper, now they making it like you gotta be, you gotta pop them in, gotta get an off. Now they off.
Well, I got a history of it. They gotta know like you really like. You feel me? Like,
yeah, like that. As long as your music speak to you right now, you can switch it up. As long as you speak to the people, you can speak to a freak nigga out there, and you can speak to a female who's going through something. You win. You don't really gotta be for them. You know what I'm saying?
But that's what that's what I'm getting to. Like, you don't. So for the young listeners, like, you don't gotta be for the nigga. You don't gotta talk about it and make it. Like, I feel like the most music that I like the most. Well, I feel like the most music that really blow. You feel me? It be the shit that everybody can relate to. Drake say he. So I listen to this Drake thing, right? Drake interview.
I listen to the violent shit. I ain't gonna lie.
Longevity. Like, what's gonna get your people paid? Because other shit gonna get you famous and dead. You know, a lot of them get them famous and dead as fuck. Like, this nigga King Von dead. And yeah, he might hit 1 billion views on his video.
He don't got it right now.
You know, he dead as fuck. He ain't gonna see it. But, I don't say with the Drake shit, he say he make music, all his music, he make music for a late night drop. And when you think about his music.
Drake be trying to talk spicy. But, he be talking about putting money on niggas' heads and all types.
But his album,
he
though.
Be trying to.
All his albums
in like a little secret way.
Yeah, you feel me?
But yeah, like, look how you do it though.
Yeah. I mean, I don't give a damn either way. I didn't say
you know what it is. Yeah.
That's why. No time to leave that, nigga. Yeah, but I feel like music gonna win regardless, whichever way you put it. I mean, whatever you, however you do it, but I'm just saying.
How y'all feel about that? Like, how when they do the shit, they jump on live and go live and talk about it. Like, what? How you feel about that? Like, do you think they're gonna, like, when they go,
no.
Like, no, I ain't saying do you watch it, but
I don't agree with it. I don't like it. It's not. It don't make sense to me. I don't want you to keep up with it.
Yeah.
Honestly, I don't like that type of shit.
You ain't wrong. How you feel like being, you know, since you OG, like really?
Yeah.
So like.
Sending packs off to different artists and
I'm working well. Honestly, I've been making clothes for next month or be a year. Mm-hmm. So I honestly feel like I'm at practice still a little bit with a lot of stuff. But I'm never scared to take a chance. Like I'll jump out there.
So you talking about practice and what we be looking at. Motherfucker, you gonna get that bitch.
Yeah.
For real. As soon as you post that bitch, everybody named Mama. it didn't come. That's how it works. That's how it works.
Which, as far as your music, like, what's your plan, like, as far as marketing? Do you have a plan or that's something like
that? I think right now I've been trying to, you know what I'm saying? I've been really, right now, see, I'm getting to you. I got a lot of businesses, other businesses behind.
Oh, yeah, you got the lawn, so you still got the lawn service, right?
I got the lawn service, okay. I got the detail and shit, so, and then right now I'm trying to, just the weed out of everything, like, right now, that's my cameraman right now. That weed is like right now. That one thing, so now I'm trying to build my own studio. So once I put that studio together, I ain't got to worry about me going to spend $300-$400 with a nigga for 10 hours when I can just, you know, I can wake up out my motherfucker. See, I got a thought in my head, fam, let me get up and go. You know what I'm saying?
No, so, I'm just trying to
get all that shit together first, and then once I get all that shit together, I feel like everything gonna come. Pieces on his own. Yeah. I ain't gotta really go out there and try to look for it and be, you know, begging them off for, hey man, I need, you know, this right here. I just, you know, pray on it and let everything come together.
Yeah, that studio and that constant content on Moody.
Yeah.
You feel me? Having that cameraman on deck.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't know that content is really what make a difference. Like giving people, like, it's just like even with your clothes, like you have to post pictures.
That's true.
You feel me? Like, it builds your fan base.
It definitely
do. It really do.
And they want to see consistency.
Yeah.
I'm trying to tell my daughter that, you know. Shout out to her too. Shout out Naya Denae. Y'all fuck with her. Go check her out. Hey. Naya Denae on all platforms.
You heard my paper?
Oh, Naya Denae. Hey, my bad.
Slide, too, though. Get out. Yeah.
Yeah, she needs slide.
Yeah.
But I be trying to get on her about that. I'm like, bro, you got to be consistent. You got to. You got to stay on top of that stuff.
Anything you want to do, I do.
Yeah.
Especially in the entertainment, you gotta stay in the phase. If you ain't doing what you really wanna do, you gotta do something to stay in their goddamn phase. Like, you just gotta stay. The
That's why I got people blowing up that ain't really their gas. But you know what I'm saying? You check them out, they have a lot of shit out there.
Yeah.
And they been pushing and building their fan. They like, damn, bro, I know I'm harder than them, bro. This person harder than that part, but you ain't working like they working. You ain't out there networking like they networking. And a lot of people, I feel like they get stuck within their city limits. They be trying to, too busy trying to impress people
right.
from the city. Like, bitch, if you don't get the fuck out of here, bitch, it's an invisible line to go wherever the fuck you want to go. Yeah, bitch, go promote him. You ain't got to plug in with the DJs in Orlando. Take your ass to fucking Jacksonville, go plug in with them days. You know, go to Georgia, plug in with them. Friend. Yeah.
And it's free.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. Jump in their deal. Like, fuck these people. Not saying like that, I love my city, you feel me? But if you ain't getting no love here, go somewhere else. You feel me?
But see,
you can put on for your city and still network outside the city.
Yeah, you're right about that. And Orlando, one of the big, they know Orlando got a lot of talent, so.
Well, I feel like we're de-talented.
Yeah.
They got us fucked up, like, for real.
They all the other cities and stuff, they look at us, so. You might be, don't even know, motherfucker way long in Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, all down there by Miami. Yeah. Daytona, all these other little spots or whatever, they trying to book you. You know what I'm saying? Because Orlando got a lot of, we got a lot of talent here. You know what I'm saying? And motherfuckers don't be knowing just because the internet ain't based off really. Motherfucker make it based off of life. But a motherfucker will watch you all day and won't like shit.
And won't like shit. Yeah. And you definitely know that you still get into tons of people that you don't even fucking know about. You'll never know how many people you really get into. That's why, because it's been shit I didn't post it, like, for sale. That bitch might not get no life. But it's hella people in my DM, or, like, you feel me? Like, my shit sold out. Some people don't want people in their business to let them know, like, they might not want a bitch to know they listen to you. They friend might not like you, so they might want to know, I'm bumping this nigga shit in my car, you feel me? Or, I'm looking at her shit, oh, this bitch bad. They don't want their friend to know they looking at your page. Like, that's the wrong job, too. Y'all give a fuck about what other people think.
I be preaching that shit all the time. I post that shit on my Instagram.
I don't give a fuck with, like, my shit.
What?
Like,
bro,
nah,
I had,
they
bro.
Gonna see it and post them in the store.
I'm telling you.
Post that bitch in the store.
Everybody be looking.
Yeah, you know,
like, I got thousands of people in the store. I didn't know that many people knew me, bitch. Damn, hey.
Yeah, that dude's crazy. That's what happened all the time. I get way more views than
that. People that you even thought was gonna be your ass.
But yeah, man, that shit is real. That shit is true.
only 30 minutes.
Oh, yeah. Hey, bro, it's so funny. Y'all don't know, because, it was missing two more hosts.
Yeah, we missed, shout out to them going to Miami, too. How did that Miami shit go? I know I missed Miami,
was like, Miami was like, matter of fact, speaking of Miami, shout out to,
You going
to
miss her?
Yeah, Smoking Celebrities. You feel me? They got, listen. I missed Miami. Well, they Miami got that gas down there. I ain't going to lie to you. They got that gas. Tap in. This Smoking Celebrities. That's that shit on Instagram.
I missed all the ass down there. It was a real good reason. But, I mean, still.
We went to the liquor, too. I mean, not the licking. What's that other shit? Yeah, on Sundays.
Yeah, that's my man.
We went to Sundays. I can't believe I stood in line that long.
Stood in line for 3 hours.
Bro, I ain't gonna lie, bro. That food was fire as fuck. It was fire as fuck. I was like, okay, I ain't even mad. Like, okay. And you know, it was like a something that you plan anyway.
Y'all female, 3 hours? I went to Popeye's. I went to strip club.
I thought you just said you stood in line.
Huh? I wasn't in line.
I wasn't even with you. Oh, no. Not with us. I thought you might have went like another time.
No, I said everybody went, what you call it, to the licking. I don't understand.
Oh, yeah. No, that shit moved fast,
now.
But no, that shit was on point. So if y'all, you know
what I'm
saying? I ain't gonna lie. That shit was
a
good trick. Whoever fucking that bitch cooking.
Shout out to Emmy.
Emmy
on
I-95
trying to make it to the
club. Emmy, check it out, right? I know you looking. Shit, what happened to you, bro?
He was working. Knew that word.
Yeah, that boy be working.
Yeah, they be saving my dog, bro.
Yeah.
Shout out to our sponsor, too, Quiet Storm Vodka. Based out of Fort Lauderdale. It is a black-owned vodka company. You can actually find that liquor in Walmart here. Okay. So I think that's dope.
Anything black-owned is cool. You know, it's dope. Just do your business,
right? First of all, speaking of that, I was just going to say that. How y'all feel? Like, y'all know how people be like, they feel like just because they got black business, you're supposed to support them. But people don't be, like, they still getting graded, like, on their customer service. You know what I'm saying?
They be trying to get over.
I mean, I love my city, so, like, I show a lot of love.
Yeah, I support
them. These Jersey dress I got on, I fuck with them. They run for me. They support me.
They say hustle all the
time. Yeah, hustle.
Hustle. I like that.
Yeah, hustle more. I fuck with them. So, I mean, I show love. In my city, regardless of customer service, because I just understand that.
Oh, no, yeah, I'm going to definitely give you a chance.
Some people have good days, some people have bad days, but mostly I run across good people, good hearted people. And I give everybody a chance.
Yeah.
You want to model that motherfucker? You ain't got to be scared, man. Right. I wish I had the music. Oh,
unexpected. She's so unexpected.
Yeah, call on me on that.
Yeah,
but
that's her Instagram.
Just follow me.
Her friend got a big ass blood over there. Yeah,
I
hope you're the church folk and watching.
You know, that'll be if you watch the video, but first of all, the church people really.
I fuck with the church folk, because they cutting more than the more.
I was just going to say that.
They wild as hell, too. They getting all my pajamas
together.
You
know, see, I
asked,
what did you say? I could be at church every Sunday.
They getting all my pajamas together. For real.
They
do
it close to me, too.
You said
they be posting
you?
I said they good
folks.
Oh, good
folks,
yeah. I thought
that they be posting
you.
You ever had a pastor jump in DMs? I've been hearing about you pastors jumping in DMs, too.
No,
giving out tithes and shit. And good and special prayers. Yeah, special prayers.
Sound like those.
You want to lay a hand on your head.
This boy
wild
as fuck.
You gonna always say some wild ass shit, man. Anyway, you know, we've been here. We got a short cast, short day. BB over here. Go ahead and let them know where they can find you.
Instagram, official_youngBB. But my other Instagram is youngBB_2021.
Which one you
want
active on?
I kind of lost the other one, so. Yeah, follow me on YUNGBB_2021. Facebook, YoungBB Cobra. Twitter, YoungBB Cobra.
What the Cobra mean?
Crawl time, that's that snake shit. Snake shit. Nah.
Okay. They in here.
Yeah.
They in here. You
went
Jones, bro?
Yes, sir.
I already knew it. I used to be at Jones, and I'd be walking through the hallway, that's all you see. I'd be like, damn, what? I'd be able to get my ass to the house. For real. I remember that shit. Why I missed that school?
And let's see, what else, like, what you got coming up? Talk to the people.
No mixtape coming. Like I said, no pen, no pad. I got a new video. I just dropped a video, Lazarus. So if you ain't seen that bitch, go check it out. Then I got some new shit, a female video. I'm gonna do like, I'm finna do some different shit. So right now I'm finna do getting into the women.
That's
where
the money
at.
That's
where
that's gonna
be.
That's
family. Please make me shake that ass. I'm playing my every pretend that I got.
No
pen,
no pad. That shit probably gonna drop.
We'll just wanna shake our ass.
Yeah, I know that right.
What? I mean,
shut up. But like, you that mean is you saying all the wrong shit. Hey, you giving him wrong vibes.
The one song that I was really known for was Ride or Die, so, and that was a love song. And all the shit that I did was really love songs. I just promote parties, man, so.
No pen, no pad, that bitch probably be out no more than, I get a max at. Probably all the way done, probably by the end of this month. So by the end of this month, I at least have a couple videos for y'all that bitch be all the way done. It's instrumental, so don't think it's gonna be it's gonna be all instrumentals. It's freestyle shit. So yeah.
Still working on bro. Damn, I'm not making all the beats.
I just doing my own shit.
Oh, you got your own beats, brother? Yeah, we got to do it now.
You
make
beats.
I'm doing anything, but I'm my foot on my own neck. I'm
dropping my name and all that shit. It ain't.
We
here for them.
Yep, you know, yep. Fuck with
his
daughter, though.
I'm here every other day. Yeah, I don't fuck with my daughter, though. Not even they.
Yeah. Man, I was in guilt. They played that. I was like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Ain't going to. I was like,
yeah. Facebook, IG, whatever.
I was looking at some shit I forgot on Instagram. On Instagram, I think. I was like, damn, she controlled the crowd like a motherfucker.
Oh, yeah, that performance
she just had.
Yeah.
Real? You seen that shit, bro?
That girl been performing her whole life. That ain't anybody who know my child has been on her. She always been the person that's in the middle of the room. Well, she going to win dance contests, everything. Weddings, she got the family reunion, she got the parties, she the.
That's just him. You can't even help it. Like, that shit just him. But y'all, man, y'all can follow me. Antoine Miles on everything. Antoine Miles on Cash Out.
Right.
For real. That's the main one. Antoine, follow me on Antoine Miles Cash Out. Put the dollar sign in front of that first G shit. If another name pop up on that motherfucking a nigga like this, something. Is me. So, shout out to the Women's Kickball League.
Oh,
you feel me? Got the Women's Kickball League going on. Shout out to Ben Lucy, you know, for getting it started. You feel me? We got another big practice April 11th. Season starts in May. Something we put together.
Oh,
shit, my bad. Damn. Season starts in May. I'm telling her practice.
No, not
yet. Yeah, I'm trying to tell you. You know, we gonna hang out though, man. This league is for the empowerment for women. The women to get together, support each other. They got their businesses. We putting them up on banners for the games. Each game, we gonna be promoting and driving that. You feel me? So this is all about the women and the support for the women in the communities. They get all the football games, all the soccer games, all the routes, concerts. If you selling hot dog, they got the bun and the mustard and all that shit. You feel me? So give that same support and come hold her goddamn straw while she make the drinks. You feel me? So, see the starting May. Hit me in my inbox. P-Day, April 17th. Goddamn P-Day.
I'm ready for that, actually.
Goddamn.
I'm ready for that.
Yeah, I'm actually ready for that. I just feel like it's
going to
be a good
event. I know it's going to be a great event. Shout out to the,
I'm trying to boot that bitch.
Shout out to the chief, police of Apopka, you know, for reaching out about the event. The event big, man. I'm talking about the event big as shit. Like, it, man, it's big.
Now you're playing in the game. I'm trying to shoot a video out there
that day. Shoot a video out there, then. We hanging on the 18th, too, BCE Day. You feel me? That's with JJ Live and Miles Moraine. You know, that's for the kids. But
what
definitely.
BCE stand
for? Basketball Community Event. They will be out there, actually. They will be out there. We got a bus picking them up, so they'll be out there too. We got Kyle, you know, low key.
Oh, and it's an Easter egg hunt next Sunday too.
On the floor. Steve-O. Shot Steve-O.
At Eagle's Nest.
Yep, right.
Take your kids out there. If you ain't got nothing for them to do, there will be money and stuff there. That's what I heard, so. I feel like I'm
going to
take 7 out
there,
and I'm really going to find the eggs.
Real. Hey, man, we finna get y'all black as hell this summer. We outside all summer. Y'all be easy. Y'all be safe. God bless. Y'all stay focused, man.
Y'all,
thank you.
Shout out my nigga across town. Yeah.
For real.